हाय, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. दिस इज़ हरीश फ्रॉम डॉन बॉस्को पीयू कॉलेज, चित्रदुर्गा. सो इन द प्रीवियस क्लास आई वाज एक्सप्लेन्ड द प्रॉब्लम्स ऑन एक्सियोमेटिक अप्रोचेस टू प्रिंसिपल एंड देयर एक्सरसाइज प्रॉब्लम्स. सो आई हैव कंप्लीटेड थ्री प्रॉब्लम्स इन द लास्ट प्रीवियस क्लास. आई विल कंटिन्यू द सेम exercise problems. Okay, yes. So here one problem is there, problem number 4 I think, but in this class the problem is first. A fair coin with one marked on one face and six on the other and a fair die are both tossed. Find the probability that the sum of number that turn up is 3 and 12. Do you understand the problem? So here a fair coin, a coin is there, but the coin result is given like this. One face is one mark, second another face is 6 mark on the other face and finish. Actually the coin has head and tail, but one face is 1 and another face is 6 he given, and a fair die are both tossed. Again the die is thrown, means die has 6 results like 1 to 6. Find the probability that the sum of numbers that turn up is, the sum of number turn up is 3 and 12. Clear? So we have to find out two problems like 3 and 12. Yes, before we taking the solve the problem, first we should write the solution. How many sample space are these problems? Okay. Coin has faces marked with 1, 6. Actually head and tail, but here given 1 and 6. A fair coin has faces marked as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Clear? There is no alternate, so that's why I am the directly you should write the fair die has 6 result. Therefore the total number of equally likely cases is 2 into 6 is equal to 12. Understood? There are 12 samples points are there in the sample space. If a coin has 2 faces, but die has 6 faces, 2, 6, 12 sample points are there. The first one, the favorable cases 1, 2, that is only one, therefore the required probability is equal to 1 by 12. How do we get 1 by 12 means? If we get the sample space means 12, out of those 12 sample points, we will get only 1. The sum is 1 comma 2 is 3. There is only one result. That's why I am taking here 1 by 12. Clear? This problem also we can do. One more method is there. I will show that also. But here you try to understand the favorable cases, only one possibilities are there, because of if you have to adding these two number means we get the sum is 3. The sum of the number is 3. First question. Clear? And the second question, the sum is how much? 12. Is it right? So 12 barbeku antandre, we should take another result. The second problem is, what is the favorable cases here? The favorable cases is, the sum is how much? The second question is 12. Is it right? Cases is 6 comma 6. Clear? 6 comma 6. Here also that is only one cases, that is only one possibilities. The sum is 12 means 6 comma 6 between yavudu barala. Therefore the required probability is 1 by 12. Clear? Next, or this problem also we can do like this. First you should write the sample space. If a coin is tossed and a die is thrown, what are the possibilities are there? The sample space S is equal to, first list out the sample space. Clear? So one face is 1 means, that means H, like 1 comma 1, 1 comma 2. 1 means the first shows head or tail. 1 comma 3, 1 comma 4, 1 comma 5, the first one becomes a coin. 1 comma 6, maybe one more possibilities is there. 6 comma 1, 6 comma 2, 6 comma 3, 6 comma 4, 6 comma 5, and 6 comma 6. First one we should solve. The sum is 3. Is it right? The sum is 3. Which elements are coming? The sum is 3 means 1 plus 1, 2, not coming. 1 plus 2 is 3, coming. 1 plus 3, 4, not coming. Except 1 comma 2, not come all the elements. Is it right? Only you should take 1 comma 2. The first question, let E be the event that sum of numbers, is 3. The sum of the number is 3. Therefore the event E is equal to, how many elements are there? Only one element, that is 1 comma 2, which is also implies n of E is equal to one element. Therefore the probability of E is equal to, P of E is equal to n of E by n of S. N of E containing only one element, n of S containing 12 elements. Understood? I think now understood. Clear? Second one, let capital F be the event that the sum is sum of number is 12. Then how many elements containing the event F means, like only one element, that is 6 comma 6, because of 6 plus 6 is 12, which is implies n of S is equal to only one element. Therefore, the probability of f is equal to how much? N of f by n of s. N of f means 1, n of s means 12, 1 by 12. Clear? So this is the required solution. Please write down, students, and take your notes. Clear? Next we go for the second problem. The second problem is like this. There are 4 men and 6 women. There are 4 men and 6 women. Total number of 4 persons you should calculate. On the city council, if one council member is selected for a committee, one person will be selected for a committee at random, how likely is it that it is a woman? How likely is it that it is a woman? That means we should select the council means women only, not men. Understood? Then in this problem, total number of persons, how many persons are there? Totally 10 persons. That is called the sample space. N of s is equal to 10, because of there are 4 men and 6 women. 6 plus 4 means 10 persons. In this problem, the event, one council member is selected as a committee. How likely is it that a woman? We should select the woman only. That's why we should call the result like this solution. Let capital E be the event that a woman is selected. Woman is selected. Then N of E is equal to how many women are there out of 10 persons? There are 6 women. Therefore, the probability of the event P of E is equal to N of E by N of S is equal to, or which is also implies P of E is equal to how many women are there? 6 out of 10 members. If you have to simplify, 6 by 10 means we will get 3 by 5. This is the required solution. Understood? Yes. Note down. Next we go for the third problem. Like this. Third problem. 3 coins are tossed once. Find the probability of getting 3 heads. Second is 2 heads, at least 2 heads, no head, 3 tail, exactly 2 tails, no tail, at most 2 tails, and the last one, at most 2 heads. Actually, at least 2 heads. After that, the problem is at most 2 heads, but we should solve one by one like this. Clear? So try to understand the problem here. 3 coins are tossed once, then what are the possibilities of outcomes? See, either we have to toss the same coin 3 times, or 3 coins are tossed once. Both are same. Then what are the possibilities of outcomes? So we will get 8 outcomes. Is it right? If a coin is tossed 3 times. Clear? Then first, before we taking all these problems, first you should take the sample space. The sample space S is equal to, there are 8 sample space are there. Which are those? Means triple H, HHH, HHT, HTH, HTT, THH, THT, TTH, TTT. So these are the possibilities of outcomes if a coin is tossed 3 times, or A coin is tossed three times or three coins are tossed once. Then number of s is equal to, it contains how many elements? N of s is equal to, there are 8 elements are there. Clear? First question, he asked 3 heads. So first you take, let the event A is equal to, list the 3 heads. 3 heads, ಎಷ್ಟು ಇದಾವೆ ಕೌಂಟ್ ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ. ದೆರ್ ಆರ್ ದೆರ್ ಈಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಒನ್ 3 ಹೆಡ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್ ಲೈಕ್ ತ್ರಿಬಲ್ ಎಚ್. ದೆನ್ ವಿಚ್ ಈಸ್ ಇಂಪ್ಲೈನ್ಸ್ ಎನ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಸೆಟ್ ಎ ಈಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಹೌ ಮಚ್? 1. ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್? ದೆನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಪ್ರಾಬಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಪಿ ಆಫ್ ಎ? ಪಿ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಈಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಹೌ ಮಚ್? ಎನ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಬೈ ಎನ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಸ್ is equal to 1/8. This is the result of this solution. Understood? Because of the event containing only one element, out of the sample space 8 elements, 1/8. There is only one result are there. Sample space alli triple h anadu only one ide. Alva? So next question, 2 heads. So list out the event B is equal to, write down 2 events, 2 heads, like HHT, next to HHT, 2 heads, HTH, THH, only the event B containing 3 elements. Then which is implies n of b, number of element in the b is equal to 3. Then probability of the event b is equal to what? 3/8. Understood? 3/8. That means the probability of the event b containing 3 element out of 8 elements, out of 8 elements alli double h na eshtu idave? 3 elements idave. That's why 3/8. Clear? Third question. Question number 3. The question number 3 is at least 2 heads. Question number 3 is at least 2 heads. Minimum the event contains 2 heads. Means like triple HT. Maximum HT bekadre irbodu. Triple H. Next HHT. Next HTH. ಮಿನಿಮಮ್ 2 ಹೆಡ್ಸ್ ಇರಬೇಕು. ಟಿ ಹೆಚ್ ಎಚ್ ಒಂದು ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ದೆನ್ ವಿಚ್ ಈಸ್ ಇಂಪ್ಲೈನ್ಸ್ ಎನ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಿ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಸೆಟ್ ಸಿ ಈಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 4. ದೆನ್ ಎನ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಿ ಈಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 4 ಆದರೆ ಪ್ರಾಬಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ದ ಈವೆಂಟ್ ಸಿ ಈಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ವಾಟ್? ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಎನ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಿ ಬೈ ಎನ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 4/8. 4/8 means like 1/2. This is the required solution. So understood? Yes. Next we go for the fourth question. The fourth question is like this. No head. Fourth question is no head. Yes. The fourth one is no head means the event D containing how many elements? Only one element, that is called TTT. So the event containing no head, there is no single head, it contained only TTT. Then how many elements are there in the event D? Means only N of D is equal to only one element. Then the probability of the event P of D is equal to N of D by N of S is equal to 1/n of s containing 8 elements. 1/8. Understood? Yes. Next, so fifth question. The fifth question is like this. Three tail. Three tail means the event E is equal to, It is also containing how many elements? Only one element, that is called triple T. Then n of E is equal to 1. Then probability of the event P of E is equal to n of E by n of S 1 by 8. This result is also 1 by 8. And sixth question, exactly two tails, exactly two tail. So hagadre, the event F containing how many elements? Exactly two tail means, like HTT, THT and TTH. Therefore, it containing how many elements? 3 elements. Then n of f is equals to 3 elements. Then probability of the event P of f is equal to n of f by n of s. N of f is 3. N of s means 8. The total result is 3 by 8. Next question number 7. No tail means the event G is equal to it containing how many elements? No tail, only one element, that is called HHH. Yavondu single element allu kuda tail barabadu, andre only triple H matra irbeku. Then n of G is equal to 1. Then probability of G is equal to 1 n of G by n of S is equal to 1 by 8. Understood? Next question. Question number 8. Question number 8 is at most 2 tail. At most 2 tail ginta jaasti irabadu. At most 2 tail here, except triple T illa andru kuda nadiyutte. G H is equal to the H containing the events triple H, HHT, HTH, HTT, THH, THT, TTH. Then P of H is equal to total how many elements? N of H, number of element H, 7 by 8. Then P of H is equal to N of H by N of S. N of H means 7 by N of S means 7. Because of N of H containing only 7 element, don't write by 8. That's called probability of the event H agbidatte. Understood? That's why only 7 by 8 is the answer. And the last question, 9th one is there. That 9th is, question is like this. At most two heads means the event I is equal to next event HHT. The elements are HTH, THH, HTT, THH, TTH and TTT. At most two heads, and two heads ginta jaasti barabadu except triple H illa andru kuda nadiyutte. Then n of I is equal to it containing 7 elements. Then P of I is equal to n of I by n of S. N of I containing 7 elements and n of S containing 8 elements. The answer is 7 by 8. This is the required answer. Understood? Please note down and write down the solution in your notes. Don't be neglect, okay? Yes. Next we go for another problem. Okay. Next question is question number 4. If 2 by 11 is the probability of an event, what is the probability of the event not A? If the event A means 2 by 11 is the probability of the event, then what is the probability of the event not A? Do you know how to find out? Very simple. What is the formula for first the probability of event P of not A? P of not A means 1 minus P of A. Is it right? So which is also equals to 1 minus P of A means element is? P of A element is 2 by 11. 2 by 11 means 11 minus 2 by 11. 11 minus 2 means 9 by 11. This is the required solution. This is called not an event. If the event P of A means 2 by 11 adre, then what about not A? 1 minus P of A agutte. Not A. Because of not A means P of A dash antartha. Not antandre. Is it right? That's why 1 minus P of A, 2 minus 2 by 11. Answer is 9 by 11. Clear? Next we go for another problem. Yes, students. See here, the question number 5. A letter chosen at random from the word assassination, find the probability that letter is a vowel and a letter is a consonant. So here there are two problems are there in the given word assassination. So before we solving vowel and consonant, first you have to write the word assassination. A-S-S-A-S-S-I-N-A T-I-O-N. So in the word assassination, how many letters are there? So totally we have 13 letters. Like N of S is equal to 13. Out of 13 elements, first we have to find out the vowels. Like let capital E denotes. Capital E denotes vowel. Then list the elements E. The set E is equal to, which are the vowels? A appears how many times? 3 times, triple A. And I appears 2 times. And O appears only 1 times. These are the vowels. And second one, let capital F denotes consonants. So which are the consonant except vowels? Consonant. Clear? Then F is equal to how many elements are there in the F? S. How many total S? There are 4 S. N, T, N. Understood? Here it containing 7 elements, but here 6 elements. 7 plus 3, 13 elements. Is it equal to sample space? Is it right? Then first find out N of E. N of E containing how many elements? 6 element. N of F containing how many element? 7 element. Is it right? Then what is the probability of the event P of E? P of E is equal to formula N barithira P of E do. P of E equals to what? Yes. N of E by N of S. N of E means 6 divided by N of S means how much? 13. This is the required solution, 6 by 13. Similarly, P of F is equal to N of F by N of S. N of F means 7 elements divided by N of S means number of sample space, it containing 13 elements. Therefore, P of F is equal to 7 by 13. Adre, P of E is equal to 6 by 13. So, totally, this is the required solutions. I think all of you understood the solution. Please note down and write down in your notes and work out all the problems in the probability. This probability is very important for your next year also. Clear, students? Yes, note down, take a notes. So up to here I will stop the class. Next class I will continue. Maybe in the next class the chapter will be completed. Okay? Yes. Thank you. Thank you so much.